Hallelujah, wherever you are, the greatest. Hallelujah. Let I see first your joy wherever you are. Hallelujah. Say to your neighbor, are you glad wherever you are? Are you glad? Are you glad? I don't know, my elders, are you glad you too? And our pastor, are you glad you too? Shout the greatest hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Amen.
This small message.
Message kido.
What so I've got for the congregation?
Juya mukutano.
A small message.
Message kidoko.
One day,
siku moja,
I've been praying.
Nilikuwa niko na
omba. The time so I'm praying,
wakati nina omba,
I envy the children of my Lord.
Watoto ya Mungu
are crying.
Peko na ria.
Are not in peace.
Hapana msalama.
Now I say,
asa mimi nasema,
what am I going to do?
Tafanya nini?
What can I speak
nezi kusema
that
nini?
Day
ile
for showing them the joy?
Fura.
Now before I start this message,
kabla mimi nianze,
when you express your joy,
wakati unaonesha
it is to show that you like to live into the house of God. Shout hallelujah! Shout hallelujah! Shout hallelujah! I turn back to my preaching, what I preached long time ago, invisibility to the enemy.
Invisibility kuma adui.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Invisibility to the enemy.
Kutokuonekana kuma
adui. Or to be invisible to the enemy.
Kuya invisible.
Say to your neighbor.
Umoneche wazee wako.
To be invisible to the enemy.
Kuya invisible kuma adui.
David.
Daudi.
Was a poor. David.
Daudi.
Was born into a bad family. His family that has no a
business.
They didn't know any job. They didn't have even money. There was not even not sponsors. No one was able to sponsor them. And David was there. David was working this week. Only did everywhere. Now one day God chose him. God chose him.
Mungu akamchakula.
The same to us.
Pamoja na kwetu
shie. We were born into bad families.
Tulizaliwa kama mafamilia
mbaya. But what we know.
Lakini tunajua.
Going with what we know.
Kile tunajua.
Going with the time.
Kwenda na wakati.
Our Lord will choose us to be into another position.
Kuya mu position ingine.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I know. To your family.
Familia.
They are no professional training.
Hakuna mafundisho ma professional.
Even David himself, he had never got even a professional training, even a diploma, even a degree. To him, there was no degrees, even what. But God chose him to become king. Before becoming king, what happened to him? He had been purchased. He had been purchased by the king. And this king, before all, this king was a nice friend, a bosom friend,
ami and team.
He was a bosom friend to the king. Anytime when the king was sick, he was calling for David to play music for him, and after a time he was getting well. Some friends, some bosom friends which are living together with you, it is just today, but it is just today. Ni leo tu.
Ni leo tu.
It is just today.
Ni leo tu.
But tomorrow you will see.
Utaona.
Those are bosom.
Bale bako ba intim.
Tomorrow they can change.
Kesho
wanaweza kuchange. They become enemies.
Wanakuwa madui.
Those who are more bosoms.
Bale bako ba intim sana.
Pay attention. Say to your neighbor.
Unaonesha wazee wako.
Bosoms.
Ba intim.
Are changing in enemies.
Wanachanja kama badui.
You can't see the enemy.
Aubona kadui.
You can't see an enemy
who
are not your bosom. No. The enemy is only the person who you were chatting with in the
care,
isn't going to be with him. When a demon will possess him, he will change and become your enemy. And I want to kill you. My friend, my sister, let me tell you, when you are in bosom
with
your friends and you are not doing bad to him, even the day he will change, God will make you invisible to him. He won't see you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This man, David, was a poor. What he knew, it was only music player. He was only playing music. When King Saul was becoming sick, he was calling for this David. And when David was happening to him, after playing music, this king was feeling well and he became well. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now after that, the goodness, what David made to him, lift up jealousy to the king. The good thing what he made, lift up jealousy to the king. And the king wished to kill him. The good thing what you are making to the people, one day it is what is raising up jealousy. If you see people are in jealous to you, it is because of the good thing what you are doing. They are not jealous what is coming without the happening of the good thing. If you see in your family, your neighbors, and people you know, your bosom become jealous of you, it is because of the good thing what you are doing. He was playing music, was dancing before the king. But the time he was dancing before the king, the king burned jealous and said, no, I will kill him. And God, when David was doing good things, God was seeing the same to you. The good thing what you are doing for the people, God is seeing and God is writing. The day of enemy, when that person will become the enemy, God himself will stand up and say, no, I am a witness between you and this man, because of what he has done things what I have seen with my two eyes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say, God is the witness.
Mungu ni mushuda.
God is the witness. Because
me,
I am doing good things to my friends, but then they change in my enemies. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Shout again, hallelujah. This man hasn't got the professional training. But Saul was the best trained. He was the best in attracting people. He had got weapons, soldiers, and whoever. Ezra, as those witches are attacking you, they had got like spears or minkos. They had got them. They had got weapons. They had got quivers. Everything. But you are innocent to them. The same to David. King Saul was best trained. He knew things. He was able to attract people. When he became jealous for David and he started to attack him, God made him invisible to the eyes of King Saul. When he was attacking him, but he didn't reach him because of what? He was in a safe place. God has put you in a safe place. He's not going to let you be found. You may leave difficulties now in your finances, in your business, in your career, in your marriage, in your health. You may leave worried, panicked. What am I going to do? When I know I am in a safe place where God has you hidden, then you can live in peace. Give up on your dreams. You know God has made you invisible to the enemy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Repeat you two with me. God has put me in a safe place. He's not going to let me be found. I can live in panic today. Into my life. Into my career. Into my business. Into my health. Into my marriage. I can live worried. Panicked. What am I going to do? When I know I am in a safe place where God has I hidden, troubles can come. Troubles can come, but I don't fall apart. I know God has made me invisible to the enemy. Wherever you are, you are invisible to your enemies. They can attack you. They won't find you because of what God has you hidden. Say, God has I hidden. I inform you, don't cry. When troubles are coming, don't cry. God has you hidden. My elders, don't cry. Look at the day of troubles, the problem of sickness. Never cry. God has you hidden. You are protected. Wherever you are, you are protected. If I can read this book, he's speaking in Psalm chapter 27 and verse
5.
We can read it first so that you hear. Psalm
27
and verse
5. Inasema kwa lugha ya Kiswahili.
Yes.
Kwani kwa siku ya taabu atanificha kwa kibanda chake. Atanificha kwa maficho ya hema yake.
Yes.
Atanipandisha juu mwambani.
Daddy, have you found you too?
Papa, na wewe unapata?
Yes, 27.
Dio 27 verse 5.
Verse 5.
Verse 5.
For in the day of trouble, he will conceal me in his tabernacle. In the secret place of his tent, he will hold me. He will lift me up on a rock.
On a rock.
Français, car il me protégera dans son tabernacle. Au jour du malheur, il me cachera sous l'abri de sa tente. Il m'élèvera sur un rocher.
Yes, Bemba.
Dio Kibemba.
Bantu ansunga munsakwe yakwe.
For in the time of trouble, he shall hide me. Future.
Bantu ansunga
munsakwe.
Bantu akansunga munsakwe yakwe babushiku bwabubi. Akamfisa muchakufisa mamo cheema yakwe. Akansansabika pachilibwe ichasansuka.
In the day of trouble, our Lord will hide us.
into his pavilion,
where
we shall be hidden. In the days of problems, he will hide you into the secret place. After a time, he will lift you up on the rock. And when you stand up like
this,
people will start to see you. Same witches, same witch doctors who are quivering you, that day they will see you. You come back with glory. Say, yes, I am in a safe place where God has I hidden. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I am in a safe place. Say you too, I am in a safe place where I am God hidden high. I know whoever who is into this church,
he
is in a safe place. This is yes. Where God has you hidden, they will look for you and they won't see you.
Yeah.
It is not to say if you are in a safe place, you won't leave difficulties. No, problem will come. But even if it comes, God will make you invisible to the enemy.
Yes, that is it.
It is not to say if you are sick today because you are older, because you are a singer, you become sick. It is to say God has forsaken you. No, to be sick, we shall be sick. But our God will hide us into a secret place.
Yes,
they will see we are sick. Nothing will happen. Let God bless this preaching. So we can send up everybody. We are praying with say, Father, I need you to keep me in a safe place. Father, by the name of Jesus Christ, I know that we are in a safe place where we are you hidden us. You continue to protect your people. You are helping your people. At this place, my Father, I am commanding and say, let's be displaced by the name of Jesus Christ. By the name of Jesus Christ,
kwa jina la Yesu Kristo,
I bless this time.
Nabariki iwakati.
I bless your people.
Nabariki bantu yako.
I bless your congregation.
Nabariki mkutano wako.
Mummies,
mamam,
fathers,
mababa,
children,
matoto,
and the works,
na kazi,
what they are done
ile today. Leo.
This Sunday,
Dimash,
must be blessed.
Ibarikiwe.
By the name of the Lord,
kwa
I pray
jina
like
la
this.
Na omba ivi.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes, it is the end of the service. On Wednesday, I've got a big job. It is to say all this week. And we shall meet God with the peace alone.